Roblox finally released the studio build for their new materials, and it's pretty interesting, so let's take a look at it. But first, some context. Back in December, Roblox released images of their new high-realism materials for both parts and terrain, along with the long-requested feature of being able to use terrain materials on parts, which is great for stuff like snow, or just generally makes parts fit in with terrain, which is great for hiding things, like in the terrain with secret doors and stuff. Anyway, the release was pretty light on the details, but eventually in March we got a studio preview build allowing any user to try out the new materials in studio. Link to this will be in the description. That's worth noting, it's a separate instance of studio, so you can't upload it to any of your games and expect it to work properly. The feedback to the preview build has been mixed, but primarily positive. Quite a few materials still have issues like inbuilt colour and tiling, but Roblox has said they're going to fix these, that's not really a problem. The largest complaint I have, and what most other people seem to have, is how much the new materials vary from the existing materials, which would be fine if they were separate new materials, but Roblox said in the release they intended automatically upgrading all experiences to the new materials, which essentially means games from 10 years ago are going to look entirely different. Don't get me wrong, some of the materials are better and they do look better, but they can make significant changes to loads of games without the developers being able to have any influence over that whatsoever, unless they want to go back and change materials and colours in all of their old games, which would take a pretty long time for quite a lot of developers. Let's start by taking a look at some of the new materials and how they change existing games. I will be focusing primarily on materials for parts rather than terrain, but that's only because I use parts more than I use terrain, so I know more about how it changes things. So yeah. First we have brick, which in my opinion is one of the worst offenders because it looks completely different to the current texture. And don't get me wrong, it's a nice texture. There are loads of things I could use it for. It's great. But all the while they intend on automatically replacing the existing textures. The texture doesn't even line up in the same places as the old one. It's a completely different scale. And it's a huge amount darker, which means any build that currently has it just will not look remotely the same. You can see here that builds just look terrible with this texture if they were designed for the old texture. As before I mentioned, the giant horizontal black lines every 5 or so bricks that just stand out drastically. I'm hoping that's a tiling problem and not an intentional design choice. It better not be an intentional design choice, it's terrible. Anyway, moving on. The bricks are over double the size, hell they're probably even triple the size, and that makes such a big difference when building. You already get a huge amount of builders who build at completely different scales because Roblox is so wide and you have to decide whether you want stuff to look good for real life or whether you want stuff to be scaled like players are. The bricks are just completely different bricks, and don't get me wrong, I would love to have this material as well, but if they were to automatically roll this out on top of current games, they would look entirely different. Anyway, next we have cobblestone, which out of the new textures, probably my favourite, because the old texture has a bunch of baked in colour into it, which really limits how you can use it, whereas the new one is nice and plain. And don't get me wrong, the same rules apply, that it's an entirely different texture that's got a lot darker elements to it, which means when you start using it on existing builds, it will look drastically different. And don't get me wrong, generally speaking, I do think it looks better in almost every situation. But the fact is, some people will have planned for the exact way it looks now, and automatically rolling it out will again cause a drastic difference to how it looks. Now we have concrete, which is probably another one of my favourites, just because the new texture is a lot more versatile. The current one has big, dark splotches, which just stops you from using it in loads of situations, just because they draw your eye so much. Whereas the new one's a lot smoother and milder, and honestly, it just looks more like real concrete does. And I can't think of many situations where automatically replacing the texture with the new one would actually cause problems, because the texture's again so similar. And again, in my opinion, it just looks better across the board. And I've always wanted a texture like this. I often use decals and textures in order to make a texture that looks like this, so having a material like this would be great. Don't get me wrong, I'd like to have the old one at the same time, but if that's not possible, this is one of the materials where I'd be happy for the replacement. Next with corroded metal, also known as rust, which is not really a material I ever actually use, which is mostly because it's got such a baked-in colour that you can only ever use it if you want rusty metal, which isn't something I come across very often when I'm building. But fact is, the new material probably looks better, but it's massively different to the old one, meaning anything that tries to use the rust material for anything other than rusty metal will immediately find the new one that's completely different to the old one. Here we have diamond plate, and honestly, the new texture looks almost exactly the same as the old one. The lights are a little bit darker, and the scale of the plate itself is a little bit bigger, but functionally it's exactly the same texture as the last one, meaning. Generally speaking, it won't make any difference to any games whatsoever. The text just has the higher quality texture that looks just like the old one. Why can't they all be like this? This is what all of the improved texture should be. The old texture, but improved. Not some entirely different texture or new meaning to the name of the texture. This texture actually looks like whoever made it looked at the previous texture that it was going to be replacing and decided to make one that's actually similar. So good on you, whoever made this one. I have Fabric, which is currently a pretty useless texture just because of how pronounced the texture is. The new one's a lot blander, which generally means it can be used in a lot more places, but for some reason, the texture is orientated the opposite way to the current texture. There is no reason for this, and means any places that currently use Fabric will look entirely different and will have pieces that no longer line up properly. And it's absolutely stupid. There is no reason why they can't just rotate this texture around. It's like they ignored the previous textures for no reason. Here, Foil, which just like Fabric, isn't really used much right now because there's just not many places where you can use the material. And while the new one is a lot blander, it's also so similar to some other materials like metal or hell, even plastic. It just doesn't really have any uses. But still, if anyone has found a use for the current texture, they'll find the new texture looks entirely different and significantly less pronounced. So, guess they'll have to live with that. Now we have Force Field, which hasn't changed as far as I can tell, and Glass, which hasn't changed visually, but transparency-wise, it does seem to act a little bit differently to Glass does currently, but whether that's a bug or something they'll fix in the future, we'll have to wait and see. Now we have Granite, which is generally a texture you don't see very often just because of how pronounced the white lines on it are, meaning it can't really be used much. The new one does solve that problem, and while it is a little bit lighter than the existing texture, it's generally pretty similar, which should hopefully mean it doesn't cause any impact on existing games. And even if the material itself was significantly different, it's so rarely used, and even then, rarely in large quantities. The only place I could find that I'd used the material recently was in this reflection showcase where I use it on top of some of the chairs, and it's such a small part of the overall place that it doesn't make a huge difference when you switch it over to the new material. Now for one of the really controversial ones, the new grass, and I have heard from a few people who think the new one looks better, and don't get me wrong, it does look more like grass, but it's entirely different to the current one, which is used so massively across so many Roblox games. However, the new one does fit in better with terrain materials, and it does generally look okay, even though I think it personally looks really washed out and like bland and blurry. But excluding that, it does generally look okay. It looks so different to the current one, and it's not just the fact that it looks different, it's the fact that the current grass is used everywhere, because it's one of the most commonly used materials out of all Roblox games. You can't just change that so drastically and expect every game to look reasonable after changing it. The material is not just used for grass, it's used for stuff like leaves, it's used for bushes, it's even used for carpets in some games. There are loads of things that the grass material is used for that the new material would make look entirely ridiculous. So, hopefully, they will decide that we can have the current material and we can have the new material at the same time. But I definitely don't want the new material, which looks entirely different, blurry, darker and washed out, to override the current material, which, don't get me wrong, is literally just a noise texture. But people are used to it, and loads of games have it everywhere. You can't just change it. The current ice material is just plain and bland. You can barely tell the difference between it and materials like metal or plastic right now. The new one is very similar to the glacier terrain material we currently have, and it's also worth noting the new one currently has blue baked into it. They have said they intend on getting rid of all the colour baked into the materials. Provided they do that, the new one is a perfectly nice material. It does look drastically different to the current one, but same rules apply. Hopefully we'll be able to have both at once rather than just the new one. The new marble texture is quite different from the current one. Generally, I would say it looks good, and in most situations where the current marble material looks good, the new one does as well. But still, realistically, it's very different though, and it's almost as if they had a different use case in mind. The current one looks great with stuff like marble floors, whereas the new one just doesn't look like that's what it was meant for. It looks more like a marble worktop or something like that, which I know is a very strange distinction to make. But and it might well just be because of what I'm used to Roblox-wise, but it's just a very different texture. I would love to be able to have both, simply because the current one would look great for stuff like floors, and the newer one would look great for stuff like statues or busts, or at least There are so many different ways you could use both of them. There is absolutely no reason we should only have one or the other. I generally use the current material for modern floors, reflective floors, or fancy floors, and the new material looks perfectly reasonable in all of those situations, and perfectly reasonable in all of the places where I've used it. But that doesn't mean I want the new one to replace the existing one. I would like to be able to have just both materials so I can interchange them where I wanted to, rather than having the decision forced on me to switch over to the new one. Just because the new material is a higher resolution than the old one doesn't mean it's universally better, especially when it's such a different take on the material. The new metal texture is pretty much exactly the same as the current one. There does seem to be a little bit more scratching on the surface of it, but that might just be because the material is a higher resolution so you can see it better. Neon is exactly the same, but at the very least I can't tell the difference between the two. There might be a change, there might not, who knows. Pebble is an interesting one because the new one just looks an awful lot more like pebbles. The current material is used for loads of things, but pebbles isn't really one of them. People use it for roofs, people use it for corkboard, people use it as random textures for furniture, but because it just doesn't look that much like rocks, it just isn't used much for that. So the new material, while it looks a lot better, automatically replacing it will ruin all of the interesting ways that people have come up with to use the current texture. And honestly, it just looks like a scaled down version of the new cobblestone, which is just another argument for giving us material scaling options. Neither plastic or smooth plastic seem to have changed at all, though that makes sense given they're both pretty much the plainest textures we have. Sand is one that really annoys me because I really prefer the new texture. It just looks so much more like sand, but it's not quite so linear. But for some stupid reason, they've decided to rotate the texture around, and not only did they rotate it round, but they rotated it around by 45 degrees, which means there is no way in hell, in most situations, you can make the texture line up with how it used to. All of the cool things people used to do with the material, like wallpapers and furniture, will just no longer be able to line up neatly because of the way they changed material for absolutely no reason whatsoever. There is no reason to rotate the material, and there is even less of a reason to rotate it by 45 degrees, unless they specifically wanted to make it so the only time you could use the material is when you wanted sand. Slate is similar to grass in that it's used absolutely everywhere. This current slate material is used anywhere in Roblox where you want any type of rock or stone. That means changing the material from a rough, stony looking texture to a really smooth slate one will make such a drastic difference to loads of Roblox games. You can see here that any type of cave system has an entirely different feel to it because of the way the new material looks. When trying to use it for a more processed stone look, the same applies that it looks entirely different. And again, arguments can be made it looks better, but it's such a big difference that you should be able to have both textures and use them where you want to, and not just replace everything with a newer texture just because Roblox wants to make everything look a bit more modern. Now we have wood, which is a weird one again because the material is very similar to the current one and looks pretty much the same, just the higher quality, with the notable exception of the pink slash red splotches all over the material that I have no idea why they're there, because if they were editing out the colour in it, surely they would have edited out all of the colour and wouldn't have left some pink or red splotches in there. But either way, that's almost certainly a bug and something they intend on removing. So, ignoring the red splotches, I would say overall it's a much nicer wood texture, but it's a little bit more pronounced and a little bit less random. So in most situations, I would say it looks better and a bit cleaner as well. It is worth noting though, there is currently what looks like a slight tiling issue, as when you look at it from a distance, there is a noticeable dark and light grid. Presumably Roblox intend on fixing this as well, so just like the red splotches, we should probably ignore it. It would still be nice to have both materials so we can have variation for different wood types, but overall, I think the new one's perfectly fine. Finally, we have wooden planks, which is a really interesting one just because I don't understand what they were going for here. The new one just looks blurred and washed out compared to the current one. And not only that, but the current one tiles every one stud, which is great for any builds that are built to that increment. The new one, for some reason, increments every 0.8 studs. Which in my case is great, because I often build in 0.8 studs. But for literally anyone else, it is an absolutely terrible change that will cause any existing sets of planks to just not line up nicely. If they add the option for us to choose our own scales for materials, that would solve the problem. I somehow doubt they're going to do that, so I really hope they change the tiling rate so it matches the current texture, just so it doesn't ruin anyone's current builds. To conclude, if I haven't already made my opinion pretty clear, I think the idea of automatically overwriting all of the existing materials with new ones is a completely and utterly terrible idea, just because it will change so much about existing games. And while Roblox did suggest the idea of having some games with old materials and some games with new materials, I personally see absolutely no reason to add confusion here. Why not just make it as simple as having both sets of materials in the same game? Just give them different enums or different names. It really doesn't matter, it would not be hard. The only downside is making the material list on Studio a little bit longer and a little bit more complicated. And the upside is massive, allowing developers so much more choice in what materials they want to use in different situations, and just generally not changing and ruining people's existing builds. There is no reason to. I really do think it is a good thing that Roblox have been asking for people's opinions on this before they roll it out. But realistically, they should have known long before this what people's opinions would have been. No one wants the backlog of games to have significant changes to how they look for no reason. There have been changes like this before and none of them went down well. This is an even bigger change than any of the previous ones, and there is no reason why they can't just allow people to have more materials rather than replacing the existing ones. Roblox have continued to update these new materials, so hopefully they are looking at the feedback from users, and hopefully they will change their mind about overwriting existing games and existing materials. I think it is quite likely they will listen to the feedback just because of the sheer amount of it, and they wouldn't have asked if they didn't want an answer. If Roblox do release any significant updates regarding this, I will put them in the comments below, but in the meantime, thanks for watching.